Hello everyone and welcome you all in your maths class. Today I am going to start our 15th chapter that we already started in our previous video. So today I am going to continue it, chapter number 15, introduction to graph. So today we have to see exercise 15.2 in which we have to see about line graphs and linear graphs. So in previous video, our first video of 15.1, in that we discuss about the line graph. So let's see what is it. A line graph displays data that changes continuously over periods of time, or we can say a line graph consists of bits of line segment, means it contains the parts of line segment that join consecutively, and we join all this line segment, so that make a line graph. Now a line graph which is a whole unbroken line is called a linear graph. When line graph it is joined continuously and there is no breaking line, okay, that means a whole unbroken line, it is known as linear graph. That means in linear graph we get a straight line. So let's see about it in the exercise, so you have more clear about it. So exercise 15.2, it's question number first. Plot the following points on a graph sheet. This one we have to show on our graph paper. So our first question, we have given these points and we have to see that verify if they lie on a line, means after making it we have to find out that they lie on the same line or not. So let's see, here we have given point as A 4,0, B 4,2, C 4,6 and D 4,2.5. So I already explained you in our previous video that here these points are known as coordinate of points, where first point is of x coordinate and second point is of y coordinate, okay, that means here 4 is of x axis point and 0 is on y axis. So let's see how to draw it. So our first point is 4,0. So we know this horizontal line is known as x axis and this is the vertical line which is known as y axis. As here points are given between 0 up to 6, here maximum is 6, so we draw it on both the side, start from 0. So 0 is the origin where x and y both are 0. Then this side also we make up to 6, 7 or we can make up to 9. Similarly, on y axis also we take the point up to 9. Now, after making this point, we have to see that the distance between all the points must be equal always. Then we have to plot the point. So, our first point is 4,0. So, first point 4. And 4 we have to see on x axis. So this is the x axis. So x axis 4 is here. So we make the dot here on 4. Then we have to see 0 of y axis. So y axis is here. So y axis 0 is on that point. So horizontal we have to see x axis point and vertically we have to see y axis point. So this is the point where we get 4,0. Then second one is B, which is 4,2. So 4 again on the same line and 2 on y axis. So we have 4,2, that is B. Then C we have 4,6. So 4 is on the same line on x axis and 6 we have to see on y axis. So this will meet on that point. So here we mention C, that is 4,6, and next one is D, which is 4,2.5. Now 2.5 is not given here. Here given 2 and 3. So 2.5 comes between 2 and 3. That is in that center. So from here we have to make point D. So 4 of x and 2.5 of y, that is point D. Now these are all the points, okay, which we have to join. So now after joining, what we are getting? They all lie on the same line. So our answer is yes, A, B, C and D all lie on the same line. We verify it. Now it's second. In second you have given point as P 1, 1, Q 2, 2, R 3, 3 and S 4, 4. So now let's check it. So 1, 1, that means again you have to draw x-axis and y-axis. On x-axis we plot the point and on y-axis also we write the point 1 up to 9. So here 1, 1, P is 1, 1. So 1 of x and 1 of y, that means this point. So we have to make one dot here and write here P, and in bracket we write the name of point, that is 1, 1. Then second is Q. Q is 2, 2. So 2 of x and 2 of y. So we get this point. So here we mention 2, 2. Then R is 3, 3. So 3 of x and 3 of y. So in bracket we write 3, 3 and the point name is R. And next one is S. S is 4, 4. So 4 of x and 4 of y. So it is 4, 4 and we get point S. Now we have to join all 4 points P, Q, R and S. So what we are getting? Again we are getting the straight line. They all lie on the same line. It is again verified. Now third one. In third you have given point as 2, 3, 5, 3, 5, 5 and 2, 5. So now let's check it. So in third again we draw all the point. So as we draw this point K, 2, 3, so 2 of x, 3 of y, then 5, 3, so 5 of x, always first point of x and second point is of y. So 5 of x, 3 of y, so it is L. Then 5, 5, that means 5 of x, 5 of y. Then N, 2, 5, so 2 of x axis and 5 of y axis. Now we join all the points. So are they lie on the same line? No, they not lie on the same line. We are getting this rectangular shape. Okay, so our answer is no, they are not lying on the same line. Now see, it's question number 2. Draw the lines passing through 2, 3 and 3, 2. Aapko kya karna hai? Draw karna hai. One line which is passing through these two points, 2, 3 and 3, 2. And also find the coordinate of the point at which the line meets the x-axis and y-axis. And after making, you have to draw the line up to the x-axis and y-axis and find out where they meet. So let's check. Here from the graph we have clear, it is given that we have to draw these two points, 2, 3 and 3, 2. So first we draw x-axis and y-axis and write the points there. Then first we draw 2, 3. So 2 we have to see from x-axis and 3 we have to see from y-axis. So we get this point 2, 3. Then we have to draw second point, that is 3, 2. So 3 of x-axis and 2 of y-axis. Now we have to join both the points. Now when we join these two points, then we have to draw it up to the x-axis and y-axis. So whenever you draw this line up to x-axis, then you get which point? 5, 0, because it meet at point 5, and here x is 5 and y is 0, and when we extend it up to y-axis, then we get point 0, 5, because here y is 5 and x is 0. It means we are from the graph, it is clear that the line joining the point 2, 3 and 3, 2 meet at x-axis at point 5, 0 and y-axis at point 0, 5. So in this way we have to draw the graph. Okay, now let's see exercise 15.3. In 15.3 you have to draw the linear graph. So I told you what is linear graph, it is a unbroken line. Okay, let's check by the solutions. Now question number first, we have first question: draw the graphs for the following tables of values with suitable scales on the axis. Here you have given this table. In this table you have given cost of apples. So in first column you have given number of apples, and second column you have given cost in rupees. So when apple is 1, then its cost is rupees 5. When apple is 2, then its cost is 10. When number of apples 3, then its cost is rupees 15. When it is 4, then its cost is 20. And when it is 5, then cost is 25. So you have given here, draw the graph for that. So for this, what we are doing, we are observing here that number of apples are given and cost is given. So take a proper scale. Scale we have to choose ourselves according to the question. So for x-axis we are taking 1 unit equal 1 apple, because number of apples are given as 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Then on y-axis we are taking 1 unit equal rupees 5, because they are increasing as 5 table, 5, then 10, then 15. So we are choosing scale in this way. Now we can mark number of apples on x-axis and its cost of apples on y-axis. Now let's see how to draw. So here on x-axis our scale is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, because number of apples are given in this way. So we write these numbers in this order, and cost is given as 5, 10, 15, 20. So scale also we are choosing in the same way. So we write here 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 and 30. So according to our question, these are the points. First point is 1, 5. Second point is 2, 10. So we draw in the same way like we drawn in previous exercise. So 1, 5. So 1 of x axis and 5 of y axis, that is 1, 5. Then 2, 10. So 2 of x axis and 10 of y axis. Then 3, 15. So 3 again of x axis and 15 of y axis. Then 4, 20. So 4 of x axis and 20 of y axis. Then last 5, 25. So 5 of x axis and 25 of y axis. Now we join all the point. So which type of graph it is? Linear graph, because it is here we are getting a straight line and there is no unbroken line. So this type of graph is known as linear graph. Okay, then in second you have given distance traveled by a car, and here time is given 6, 7, 8 and 9 am, and here distance is given in kilometer, which is 40, 80, 120 and 160. So we have to plot the graph for this. So here again on x-axis we are taking scale as 1-1 hour difference. Okay. So 6 a.m., 7 a.m., 8 a.m. and 9 a.m. And on y-axis, we are taking the difference of 4 table. So 40, 80, 120 and 160. So here, first point we have 6, 40. So 6 of x-axis and 40 of y-axis. Now here you are observing this type of line. So this is known as kink. This is the breaking line. Because here we are starting directly from 40. That's why we are making this type of kink here. Okay. So whenever you take any number directly, not from 5 or 10, or if you are choosing any bigger number, then you have to draw this kink. Okay. Then plotting is the same. 6 of x and 40 of y. Then 7 of x-axis, 80 of y-axis. Then 8 of x-axis and 120 of y-axis. And last 9 of x-axis and 160 of y-axis. Now we join all the points. So again we are getting a straight line, which is again a linear graph. So here you have asked one question also. How much distance did the car cover during the period 7:30 a.m. to 8 a.m. So beta, you have to see between 7:30 to 8. So that much. So we have to go up to this straight line. So this line showing this point and this point, that means comes between 80 and 120. And between 80 and 120, that is 100. So 100, here comes 100 kilometers. So during the period 7:30 a.m. to 8 a.m. the car cover a distance of 20 kilometer, because this is 100 and 100 minus 80, it is 20. So car covered the distance of 20 kilometer. Then one more question it has. What was the time when the car had covered a distance of 100 kilometer since it start? So when it start, then that time the car covered a distance at 7:30 a.m. since it start. So just now we have seen that from 100 it is goes up to 7:30 a.m. So in this way you have to give the answer of the graph also. Now see, it's question number 2. Draw a graph for the following. Here also you have given sides of a square and perimeter in centimeter, and then you have to ask that is it a linear graph. So you have to take the first column as x and second column as y. So our points are 2, 8. So 2 of x-axis and 8 of y-axis. Same 3, 12, 3 of x, 12 of y. Then 3.5, that it comes between 3 and 4. So 3.5 and 14 also comes between 12 and 16, because here scale we choose as 4. So 4, that means the difference between them is 4 kilometer. Okay. Whatever scale you are choosing, that you have to see the number comes between them is the difference of there. Like here 4, here 8. That means between them which number comes? 6. Then here 8 and 12. In between them 10 is there. So 12 and 16, in between them 14 is there. So in this way you have to plot the graph. So again you are getting the straight line. So straight line, so it is a linear graph. Yes, it is a linear graph. Then it's second one you have given as side of a square and area of square in centimeter square. So side you have given in first column and area you have given in second column. Then you have to plot its graph. So we are choosing here for x-axis 1 unit equal 1 centimeter and on y-axis 1 unit equal 4 centimeter. According to question, always we have to choose the scale. So here what we are observing, we are making the graph same as previous question, but here we are getting 2, 4. So 2 of x axis and 4 of y axis. Same way 3 of x axis and 9 of y axis. Now making all the points in the same way. So 5, 25, 5 of x, 25 of y. Now 25 comes here between 24 and 28. So you have to count the number of lines also between them. Now afterward we have to join all the points. So when we join all the points, then we are not getting a straight line. It means it is not a linear graph. So whenever you are getting the straight line, then only it is a linear graph. But here we are not getting a straight line. It means it is not a linear graph. So in this way you have to plot the graph. Okay, so this chapter get over. Now make practice to draw the graph. Okay, that's all for today's video. Now we will meet in next video. Till then, take care and bye bye.